Okay, I've got the main gear cluster in, turned the box upside down, so now I've got to try and get the lay shaft in and through the washers and try to lined up. It's easier said than done. Where's my lay shaft in? Let's turn it around. Locating on the reverse tab. Phew! Not a ball bearing. A couple of bolts in the back so it doesn't fall off. Centered up. That's centered up. That seems like the specified torque. Right, what's next? Temporarily put the flange in with no oil seal and fix it later. Put the nut on, stop it all falling apart. Yeah, and the spanner on suitable size, okay. Quarter. This is the reverse lever mechanism. What I've done is I've machined this ramp down so it's flush with the other ramp, so the gear lever will slide right across without the need to lift it up. I've still to put the stop bar pin back in. I'm going to take it out and do that. What I had to do is, because I ground it down so low, I had to build up with braze on that face there, otherwise it would had a bit of a step forward here, and then ground it down just so I clear the other rods. So I'll just put the pin back through there and then and reinstall it. Got the new gasket stuck onto the front cover plate, and then that needs to go that way up. We've got a new oil seal in there. So it should slide in there. Well, I declare that a success. I'm now able to get it into reverse gear. So it's reverse without having to lift it. It's not very well clamped in at the moment, but yeah, not very well clamped in and trying to do it left-handed, but it now has all the gears. Quite difficult with the shortened gear stick, of course. There's a remote gear change rod comes out here that bolts on. I had to straighten the gear lever a little bit back here and then drill a hole in it, and then the yoke bolts onto that. So I've got new mounting rubbers for the back, but I'll need to make a mounting bracket to mount it into the tunnel, because this has a different mount compared with the earlier Reliant Regal box. This is a Reliant Robin box, I think. As you can see, I've also had to do some modifications here to give me clearance to get in the tunnel. I've chopped off the face where the starter motor goes. There is a metal ring on the motor plate that gives some support around here, so it shouldn't be a problem. And then at the front, I've drilled and tapped for two holes here to take the original type pivot mount for the clutch release lever. Clutch release lever comes in here and pivots, then pulls the clutch release bearing. You see them here, a couple of holes here and here, and normally a shaft comes right through and then operates the lever this way, with a lever coming out here. But this goes totally the opposite direction from the earlier version. So this one you have to, well, which way is it? Pull back the way to push the clutch clear, whereas this one it pulls forward to move it. What else have I to do to it? I had to ground down the input shaft here so it would go in the spigot bearing in my flywheel, and still to put in a couple of threaded studs in there to locate it when I install. I've still to put a gasket on here. I've just bolted that down to see how it goes. It all seems to select all the gears, which is good. I'm going to ground down the little saddle in there so that you can go right across the reverse and get it in reverse without having to lift it. So the next job is to put it in here. I need to cut off that mount that's on the chassis there and make up a new mount and bring it up to the same height as this, so the prop shaft's in the same position. I shall attempt that tomorrow, I think. Just been making a bracket to support the back of the gearbox. That slots on there. Slots on like that. Has to be slotted because these are at an angle, otherwise you couldn't lower the studs onto there, so you have to slide it on from the back, and then this piece will bolt to the chassis. But first I need to cut off the two brackets that are down there. So I've got my plasma torch out, and I'll do that very shortly. So that's the bracket sitting in the right place, it's the right height as well. I measured it to this centre, this bolt down to the cross member before I took the other gearbox out. that's back to the same dimension. So all I need to do is drill two holes through there and weld in a couple of captive nuts into the existing bar underneath, and then bolt it down. It went in surprisingly easily. I did cut away part of the bell housing to give me extra clearance. I trimmed away the corners that were fouling on the bulkhead. It lets me get it in easier. There's still enough strength with this motor plate to cope with anything. It dropped in quite nicely. Right, I'll go and mark the positions of these holes, drill two holes, mark the cross member, and then weld in a couple of captive nuts. Right, I've welded in two nuts into the cross rail there. I'll take my new bracket. Just got to re-secure my petrol pipe down there. Then I can get the gearbox back in. I've replaced the rubber bushes at the back of the gearbox mount with some nylon bushes that I made up. I can see those. Just 3/8 bolts straight through them, and then two nylon blocks. That's certainly taken the movement out of the engine and gearbox. It was coming back about 1/8 of an inch when you pressed the clutch in before, so that's stopped that now. Sitting up in axle stands at the moment because I've just been replacing the tyres. So it's now got brand new Formula Ford 1600 Avon ACB 10s, 6x21x13s. Hopefully they'll be a bit stickier than the 4 or 5 year old ones that were on it.